we're going to start with section 7.1, which is solving linear equations. I have found that this is typically a review for most people. However, if this is something you struggle with, you need to figure it out, okay? Because solving a linear equation, we're going to do a lot of different stuff, but in the end, it typically comes down to solving a linear equation in this class, okay? So you need to know how to do this. Again, it might be a review. Some people might be bored, but it's going to be helping somebody. Okay, so I always write the section that we're doing at the top so that you can go back in the textbook and look to see if you have any questions, if you want extra examples, anything like that. Section 7.1, linear equations. If you ever can't read my writing, let me know too. Okay, A, solving linear equations. All right, we have forms. The first form we have is standard form. So a linear equation in two variables is an equation that is of the form AX plus BY equals C, where A, B, C are real numbers. That are not zero. Okay, can you guys read all of this? Don't hesitate to ask. Sometimes it gets a little scribbly. Does anybody know another form for a linear equation?
Fractions?
For a linear equation? What's a form?
I don't really know the form names themselves, but I kind of know, like, you know, specific things that are in them and how to do them.
Well, I'm looking for the form right now. So let's focus on what the form is. What's another form for a linear equation? Good. What's that called? Slope-intercept. Good. Good. Slope-intercept form. So a linear equation in two variables is an equation of the form what's that form, Michael? You said slope-intercept form, but what is that? Who can help?
Y equals mx plus b. Yeah.
You tell me. You guys said slope-intercept form. Yeah, y equals mx plus b.
Yeah, you're saying it first.
Yeah. As of the form, you guys all know this, but you just have to bring it back. Right? Maybe it's been a while. Y equals mx plus b, where m is?
M and b are actual numbers.
What is it?
M is the slope.
It's your slope. And b is?
Intercept.
What intercept? Y-intercept. Good. What the heck is the y-intercept?
It's for graphs.
Where do I find it on the graph?
Like it's the y-axis.
It's where your function crosses the y-axis. Good. So let me just think about that for a minute. All right. Which one's my x-axis? Which one's my y-axis? Oh, gosh. It's been so long. It was a long winter break.
X is reverse.
X is this.
Y
is
vertical.
Here's the y. Okay, so I'm going to draw a bunch of linear equations. What does a linear equation look like on a graph?
A line.
Linear means line, right? Straight line. No curves, no bends, no turns, no corners. It's a straight line. Oh, my gosh. Wow. I'm so good at this. Look at all these linear equations. These are my linear functions. Okay, where's my y-intercept again? Somebody said it. Where it crosses the y-axis. So here's a bunch of y-intercepts. Y-intercept is where my function crosses the y-axis. What do you know about the y-intercept? You know anything?
X equals 0.
X equals 0. Awesome. So the y-intercept is 0b, some point. It's a point. X always equals 0, right? Here, I go over 0, up something, over 0, down something. It's a point, right? Good. Does every linear equation have a y-intercept? No? This one doesn't, right? Oh, well, this one does. Does everyone? You have undefined what? What do you mean undefined? So when it's vertical, what's undefined about that? Something's undefined. What is it?
Slope.
The slope is undefined. Good. Good. By the way, what the heck is slope? Oh my goodness. Let's write that down. We verbally defined what the y-intercept is. I didn't write it down, right? What is it again? The y-axis. Y-intercept is where my function, or in this case, my line crosses the y-axis. Again, I didn't write that down, but we did define it, right? So no matter what, I can look and see where it is. Okay, but let's define slope. So I like to put the important things in boxes usually. This is a definition. So I'm going to put it in a box after I'm finished writing. Okay. If we have 2 points. What? Is it not legible?
No, I can read.
Okay. Sorry, sometimes it does feel a little.
No, I can read.
Okay. Points x1, y1 and x2, y2. Then the slope. I'm defining slope, so I'm underlining. Then the slope is, uh-oh, somebody help me. What is the slope? What's the slope? Why do you keep covering your mouth when you're answering questions? You're right. It's good. Rise over run. Rise over run is very helpful if you're looking at a graph, right? Rise. I'm rising, I'm running, right? So I'm doing a little dance with my hands. It's another way to say rise over run. Change in. Don't make me keep doing this awkward dance. Change in. Height, what's the height?
Y.
The y, good. Change in y over change in
x,
good. Okay, in terms of my, can somebody put that in terms of my 2 points? So I have 2 points. How do I calculate the slope?
Y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1.
Y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1. Good job, Luke, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Good. So notice that Y2 and X2 come first in this. Don't do Y2 minus Y1 over X1 minus X2. Don't switch the order of these. do the one of the points first and one of the points second, okay? So you have to label and just stay organized. It's a really simple computation, but if you're not organized, it's easy to switch stuff up. Okay, you guys all remember this, right? It's been a while.
I haven't taken math in a year and a half, so.
Gotta bring it back.
I'm not even good at math to begin with. Well, sometimes I am, but oftentimes in non-hands-on settings, I fail miserably.
You just gotta work through it. Okay, so put the following in slope-intercept form. So put the following in slope-intercept form. Let's do an example. 3x plus y equals 12. Okay, so somebody tell me what the heck I'm supposed to do. What's the goal? Put the following in slope-intercept form. What's my goal? Get y by itself. So I'm solving for y, and what do I want the rest of the stuff to look like? Y equals what? Good. So the goal is we need it to look like y equals mx plus b. Good. So I think some of people's battle with math, if they feel like they're not good at math, is clearly defining what the goal is. Put the following in slope-intercept form. If you go, what the heck does that mean? You don't know where to start, right? Put the following in slope-intercept form. I know slope-intercept form is y equals mx plus b. I need to solve for y. I need to get y equals other stuff. Okay? So that's our goal. All right, how do I do that? Subtract 3x. Good. So the relationship between y and 3x is addition and subtraction. So I just need to do the opposite. So I'm subtracting 3x because 3x minus 3x is 0, right? Y equals, are these, can I add these together? If so, how? No, why not?
There's an x there.
They're not like terms. So one of them has an x, one of them does not. They're not like terms. I cannot combine them. Similarly, I cannot separate them. I cannot say, oh, that's 3 plus x. Can't separate them, right? So this is negative 3x plus 12. I like to box in my answer. Who can tell me what the slope is? Y equals mx plus b. M, the number next to x, is the slope, right? So what's the number next to x in this? Negative 3. So negative 3 is the slope. And what's my y-intercept? 12. Good. All right, 4y equals 16. Okay, put the following in slope-intercept form. What's the goal? Get y by itself. Have y equals other stuff. Am I there?
Both sides by 4.
So I'm not there, so I need to do something, right? What's the operation between 4 and y? The opposite of multiplication is division. Good. So we're going to divide both sides by 4. And why is that? That's because 4 over 4 is 1, and I want 1y, right? So if y equals 4. So is this in y equals mx plus b form?
No.
Why not? Yeah? Why?
There isn't an x.
Okay, so my question is, what's my slope? So this is y equals other stuff, so it is in y equals mx plus b form. No. Something. It's a horizontal line. Good. So the question is, what's my slope? 0. Right, this is y equals 0x plus 4, right? Same thing. So the slope is 0. That means I'm rising 0, I'm running something. That's why it's a horizontal line. Good. What's b?
4.
Good. So once I have y equals other stuff, that is y equals mx plus b. Okay, so I started with some simple problems, and that was to identify the operation between y and other stuff. Here the operation between y and other stuff was multiplication. Opposite of multiplication is division. Here the operation between y and the other stuff next to y is addition or subtraction. So we do the opposite, right? I'm going to do opposite in quotes. All right, so let's kind of put those things together, okay? Three x plus 2y equals 12. All right, the directions are the same. Put the following in slope-intercept form. So somebody remind me, what's the goal?
Get
y alone. Very good. Y equals other stuff. Oh, my gosh, this one looks so much more complicated. Who can help me?
Subtract 3x from both sides.
Can you remind me what your name is?
Meadow.
Tell me what to do, Meadow.
So you subtract 3x.
Good. So the thing is I want y equals. The operation between 2 and y is multiplication. The operation between y and 3x is addition. So I want to get rid of addition and subtraction first. Good. So I'm going to subtract 3x from both sides. And that's because 3x minus 3x is 0. So I have 2y equals negative 3x plus 12. Okay, am I finished?
Nope.
Divide by 2 because this is 2 times y. The opposite of times is divides. Oh my goodness. What's my slope? What's my y-intercept? How did Meadow get that? Oh, well, I have a question. Is it, what if I do like this? Can I do that?
No.
Got to divide it all by 2. So this is very bad. Very bad. People do this all the time. That's why I'm showing you how bad it is. Don't do this. Don't be that guy. Somebody will be on a test. And this will be my comment. Very bad. So you have to divide everything by 2, not just part of it by 2. Good. So why is this? Why does that work out that I divide both by that? So let's remember how to add and subtract fractions. So remember, I said on the first two tests, you guys will have a dollar store calculator. It will not have a fraction button. So adding and subtracting, multiplying and dividing fractions is something you have to be comfortable with. Oh my gosh, somebody help me. How do I add and subtract fractions?
Find a common denominator.
Okay, I need a common denominator. Good. This one, I have a common denominator. They're both 3. So this is correct, but let's write down the math behind it. So the step that I'm trying to get to is, how do I add and subtract fractions? I add the numerators, I keep the denominators the same. So that's 1 plus 2 over 3, which is 3 over 3, which is 1. But my point is, I want to get to here, because usually we're used to adding and subtracting fractions. We get the common denominator, and then we do this, and then we get our answer. So we're going essentially from something like this to something like this. We're splitting it up, and that's why it's okay. Okay? So I'm going to write an in-between step here to show this adding and subtracting fractions thing. So I could write this as 12 over 2, right? Just split it up. So if you have one denominator, you can split up the numerator. But this is why it's legit, right? technology, it's stacked in the claim. McLeod? He's really fun to listen to. Sometimes he teaches in the lecture hall, the big one downstairs. You can hear him scream like the whole first floor. Keeps everybody awake. All right, let's do another one. X minus 1 over 4, y equals 2. So the directions are the same. Put it in slope-intercept form. So what's the goal again? Y equals other stuff. Good. Y equals mx plus b. So you guys want to try this one on your own? Yeah. All right, who can tell me the first step?
Subtract x from both sides.
Good, subtract x from both sides. The operation between y and x is addition or subtraction, so the opposite of addition or subtraction is addition or subtraction. X minus x is 0x, and that's what I want. Okay, so now I want everyone to think for a minute. Think about what to do. Who wants to give it a shot? Raise your hand. Who else wants to give it a shot? What's the operation between negative 1/4 and y? What is it? Everybody said something the first time, but I couldn't hear any of it. It's multiplication. Good. What's the opposite of multiplication? Division. So divide by sides by negative 1/4. Oh my goodness, this is super ugly. Let's do another little side note. So I'm going to do a similar thing. 1/4 divided by 2/3. Does anybody have a little saying for dividing fractions? You guys all do. Just have to remember it. So I always say dividing by a fraction is the same as multiplying by the reciprocal. What's the reciprocal? Flipped. Good. So I think a little catchy thing I always heard growing up was keep, change, flip. Yeah, same, change, flip. Different variations of something like that, right? Same, change, flip. So you keep the first the same, change division to multiplication, and flip this fraction. So some people here said divide by negative 1/4. Some people said what?
Multiply by negative
4. It's the exact same thing, right? Whether you divide by negative 1/4 or whether you multiply by negative 4, right? Negative 1/4, if I flip it, it's negative 4. So this looks super ugly, and I don't know what to do over here, right? Super ugly. But we can do keep, change, flip, same, change, flip. Multiplying by, or dividing by a fraction is the same as multiplying by a reciprocal. This is keep, change, flip. Okay, so negative 1 over 4 divided by negative 1 over 4 is 1. That's okay on this side. This is y equals. Now I'm going to do keep, change, flip. So I'm going to flip negative 1/4 and make it positive, or make it negative 4, and then I'm going to multiply over here. Again, just like up above, I needed to divide everything by something. Now I need to multiply everything by that thing. So now I'm putting parentheses so that I can distribute. Okay? So this is y equals negative 4 times negative x is
4x
minus 8. Good. Okay, what's my slope? What's my y-intercept? Everybody write it down. See if you get it right. Let's check. What's the slope?
4.
What's the y-intercept? Negative 8. Good. Make sure you carry that sign with it, okay? Negative 8, not positive 8. It's y equals mx plus b, okay? Again, I always like to box in my answer. That's part of the directions for a test. box in your answer so that I know that you know what the answer is, right? I'm not going to find it through scribbles. Box in your answer. Your goal on a test is to communicate that you know, right? How you guys feeling? Good, good. Got to bring it back, right? It's been a while. But you guys know this stuff. But the thing is that if it's something that you've struggled with in the past, don't let it affect your grade then and now, right? Figure these little details out. A lot of times people will get the order mixed up. People might get operations mixed up. But I always have office hours. I'm always available during my office hours. There's the tutoring in the library. I think it'll probably start next week. So make sure you're getting your questions answered. How do you guys feel about the fractions? Once people have a graphing calculator in high school, they forget, right? All right, let's do another one. One third x plus 1/2 y equals 4. Same directions. Put it in slope-intercept form.
Find the common denominator between fractions.
So what's the goal? Y equals other stuff. Okay. So what's the operation between 1/2 and y? Multiplication. What's the operation between y and 1/3 x? Addition. So we're going to get rid of addition and subtraction first. So let's subtract 1/3 x from both sides. That's because 1/3 x minus 1/3 x is 0. Luke? So usually when we're doing this, we need to do like a reverse PEMDAS when we're solving. So we should take care of addition and subtraction first.
Okay.
If you want to divide by 1/2, you need to divide both sides by 1/2. So you could do it, but I think when people...
It just takes longer.
I think when people do that, they forget about this.
Okay.
They don't do the whole left side. So I always get rid of addition and subtraction first, and then get rid of multiplication and division. So 1/2 y equals negative 1 over 3 x plus 4. Okay, the goal is to get y equals. So now what?
Divide by
1/2 or multiply by 2. Good, so I'm going to multiply everything by 2. Okay, so 2 times 1/2 is 1. So that's 1y. What's 2 times negative 1/3? Oh my gosh, we talked about dividing fractions. We didn't quite finish that example, huh? So right here we talked about dividing fractions. What do I do now that I have to multiply? What do you do? Well, how did we get 1 here? 2 times 1/2, how did we get 1? Yeah, so how do we multiply is the question. Across? What do you mean? Okay, so help me here. Good, so I'm multiplying numerator times numerator, denominator times denominator. Good. Just need a little refresh. It's a long Christmas break, y'all. All right, so 1 times 3 is 3. 4 times 2 is 8. Good, okay. So now We've reviewed dividing fractions. We've reviewed multiplying fractions. Multiplying, I multiply top times top, bottom times bottom. That's how we multiply fractions. Okay, so good. Okay, so that's how I got 2 times 1 over 2. Well, 2 is actually 2 over 1, and I get 2 over 2, which is 1, right? That's how we got 1y. So now what's 2 times negative 1/3? Two as a fraction is 2 over 1. 2 times negative 1 is negative 2. 1 times 3 is 3. Okay? So that equals negative 2. Oops, let me change colors. So this is like my scratch work, just writing over here. So this is negative 2 over 3x. And then 2 times 4 is 8. Good. So I just distributed this through everything, right? Luke, did you have a question? Because I'm trying to solve for y.
Yeah.
So some people said divide by 1/2. We said dividing by a fraction is the same as multiplying by the reciprocal. So 1/2 is 2.
Yeah.
Good? Okay. All right, so box it in. This is the answer. Okay, again, what's my slope? Y equals mx plus b. So m is my slope. M is the number next to x, which is negative 2/3. B is the number by itself. B is 8. Okay, good. How you guys feeling? Bringing it back? You guys awake?
Tired, but it's fine. I'll try my best anyway.
All right. So why don't I write one down, and you guys can do it on your own. So what are the directions again?
Y equals other stuff.
So get it in slope-intercept form, which means y equals other stuff. Good. This one's a little different. 1 through 5, we're all in standard form. Ax plus by equals c. This one's a little different, but the directions are the same and the process is the same. So how do you get y equals other stuff? So everybody try it on your own. I need to learn everybody's names so I can call them. All right, who wants to tell me the first thing they did? What's your name?
Brendan.
Brendan.
I subtracted 4y from both sides.
You subtracted 4y from both sides, okay? I'm going to do something different.
I added 8 to both sides.
That's what I would do, too. So the way you did it is not incorrect.
I just took the longer route.
Yeah. But that's okay. If you get the right answer, you get the right answer. But I think if you subtract 4y from both sides, then you're going to have to subtract x to both sides.
Yeah,
right? So in the end, you'll get the same, you should get the same answer.
I took an extra.
Yeah. But it's okay if you don't see that right away. Okay. So this is what I got. Now what? The goal is to get y equals other stuff. What's the operation between 4 and y? The opposite of multiplication is division. 4 over 4 equals 1, so I get y equals... Somebody help me out with this again. What did we do before?
We separated it.
Can you tell me how to write it?
So the
x over 4 plus 8. Good. All right, let's simplify. Can I write x over 4? What number is that times x? That'd
be 1. So, it'd be 1/4x.
So this is 1 over 4x
plus 2,
plus 2 equals y. Good.
You don't have to say x over 4 because...
Yeah, you can, but I specifically asked what is the number in front of x, right? If you have x over 4, you tell me the slope. If you just put an arrow to x over 4, I don't know that you know it's the number. So I want to know what the number is in front of x so that I can identify what the slope is. So this is the slope. This is the y-intercept. All right, how you guys feel? Does anybody want to see another problem, another example? Like this?
Yeah.
All right. Help me make one up, Luke. I'm not very creative, though, so it's just going to be super similar to that. Okay. 2/3 plus 5/2 y equals 1/2 x. Okay, so put the following in slope-intercept form. At this point, I'm a broken record, but what is the goal? Get y alone. Y equals other stuff. Okay, go. Ready, go. All right, who's going to tell me the first thing that they did? Is your name Carly? Okay. Subtract 2/3 from both sides. I like it. The operation between y and 2/3 is addition or subtraction, so that's what I would get rid of first. Very good. So 2/3 minus 2/3 is 0. So then I have 5 over 2y equals 1/2 x minus 2/3. Okay, who can help Carly? What's the next thing to do? Who can help? Who hasn't participated yet? You can divide by 5 over 2. What's that the same as? Multiplying by what? I can't hear you.
2/2.
Good. So we can multiply by 2/2 or divide by 5/2 and then distribute. Okay, so 2 times 5 is 10. 5 times 2 is 10. I get 10 over 10. Which is 1, so I get 1y. That's the goal. That's why we did it. We want 1y equals other stuff. All right, now you guys need to multiply these fractions and simplify and get your answer. I'll write down my answer, but you guys multiply and simplify and make sure this is something that you can do. Did I get it right? Did you get it right?
I got it almost right.
Ooh, we want it all the way right. So look at where your mistake is. Figure it out. Don't let it happen. So the slope is 1/5. The y-intercept is negative 4 over 15. Make sure you're paying attention to the sign in front of those numbers too, right? That's why I'm writing out when it's negative. Pay attention to that sign. Okay, how you guys feel? Good? You want another example? All right, so here's the thing. Oh, man, I've been sitting for a long time. So at the beginning of class, I said a couple of people emailed me. I had like 5 emails asking questions about Canvas, about Pearson, about some questions about different things. I answered those in class, right? And that's because asking questions benefits everybody. So if you have a question right now in class, get your question answered, because it's not only going to benefit you, but it's going to benefit other people. Right? So the difference, so that's why I add participation as part of the part of your overall grade, is because, again, if I sit here and I talk to myself, I get super bored. And then half the people are falling asleep, and so am I. So it's not fun for anybody, right? So I really like it when people participate, when people answer questions. Even if your answer is wrong, the thing is that somebody else might be making that mistake, and that's a learning opportunity for other people, okay? If you have a question, ask your question. If I feel like we've already spent a lot of time on it, I might say come to my office hours. But nobody is ever going to have a question that's dumb in this class. If people laugh about somebody's question, they will leave, because we're not going to do that kind of shenanigans. So questions are always welcome. And if you're asking questions, you're helping your classmates. Okay? If you want another example, and I ask, maybe people feel shy, you can just do a little, hey girl, question. Right? You have a question?
Are we going to do it the opposite way?
What? So why are we putting things in slope-intercept form as opposed to standard form? What information do we get from standard form? What information do we get from slope-intercept form? So what information do we get from slope-intercept form? We get the y-intercept and the slope. I can graph that very easily, right? Slope is a rate of change, which is a big concept in a lot of things, right? It's a big concept in like calculus, business, finance, things like that. Finding a rate of change. Math, lots of stuff. There's tons of applications for it. So we get slope and y-intercept. We can graph easily and we get more information. What information do we get from standard form? I don't know. It looks nice. That's basically it. So we could go back and forth, but I don't think that knowing how to put something in standard form is necessarily beneficial. Okay, so let's do another thing. So again, I said solving linear equations is a big concept in this class. Solving linear equations, solving for a variable, things like that. So these are all concepts that we need to know. I can tell it's review for a lot of you, but I can also tell that maybe this is something a lot of you have struggled with as well. So again, if you're struggling with it, you know where my office is, office hours, and there's the tutoring, okay? So let's do another example. So this is kind of a little bit different, so I'm doing the very technical squiggle to separate it. So here's some more examples. The directions are solve. So number 8. 3x plus 4 equals 5x minus 6. So solve, what does that mean if it just says solve?
Find x.
Right there. What do you mean find x?
Well, since there are two.
What's the goal?
Finding out what
x equals something. X equals other stuff, right? X equals a number in this case. Okay? So the goal is variable, whether it's x, y, a, b, whatever the variable is, variable equals a number. In this case, a variable would equal a number, right? All right. So how do I do that? Can somebody verbalize the steps for me?
Okay, subtract 3x from both sides, and then you get 2x.
So I don't want this specific problem. I want a verbal description of how I can solve any problem like this.
You subtract, when there are two x's involved, you subtract, like on two different sides of the equation, you subtract the lesser value x from both sides.
So what's your goal? Why are you doing that?
In order to get one x, to get the x isolated and not to have...
Okay, so the first step is to get all x's on one side.
Yes.
Okay. So get everything with an x on one side. That's the first step. Get everything with an x on one side. Get all x's or variables. Get all x's on one side. Alright, step two. Get everything without an X on the other side. W/O is without. Get everything without an X on the other side. Okay, and then the last thing is solve. Okay, so these are kind of our steps. Okay, so let's do that. So I'm going to read out these steps, and we can figure out how to do that. So first step is get everything with an X on one side. So everybody try to do that. Whatever side you want to get it to, it doesn't matter. Maybe one person subtracts 5x from both sides. Maybe one person subtracts 3x from both sides. Whatever you want to do, do it. But get everything with an x on one side. How about Quentin? What did you do? Okay, let's subtract 5x from both sides. Good. And that's because 5x minus 5x is 0x. So I'm getting rid of the x on one side. So 5x minus, or 3x minus 5x is what? Negative 2x, then plus 4 equals negative 6. All right, next thing I need to do is get everything without an x on the other side. I'm going to start calling on people. How about Lexi?
I'm just a different way where I minus the 3x from the 5.
Okay, that's fine. Can you tell me what to do here, though?
Add 4 to the other side.
Okay, so if I add 4 to both sides, I have negative 2x plus 8 at plus 8 equals negative 6. Good. So that is a lot of people's mistake, right? The thing is that this is plus 4x. This should be minus 4x in order to get to be 0. It's okay as long as you wrote it like this. So subtract 4x from both sides. And that's because minus 4 minus 4 is 0, right? So double check that. That's why I'm writing it out and crossing it out every time. So negative 6 minus 4 is what? Negative 10. Okay, good. So now I'm at step 3, solve. Okay, so I have negative 2x equals negative 10. What's the operation between negative 2 and x? Multiplication. The opposite of multiplication is division, so I'm going to divide both sides by negative 2. That's because negative 2 divided by negative 2 is 1. So I get x equals 5. Good. Even if you did it the other way, if you subtracted 3x from both sides, your answer should be the same. Okay, if you don't have x equals 5, go back through the steps and check it. Check to make sure you didn't add 4 like here. All right, so if something says solve, the goal is to get variable, whatever, if it's solve for x, solve for y, solve for smiley face, whatever it is. Solve for that thing, the goal is to get that thing equals other stuff. All right, so let's do another. 4 minus 2y equals 8 plus 3y. All right, so this is set up very similarly to number 8, so I want you guys to try it on your own. Walk through it, go back and check your work, and follow the steps that we just wrote down. I didn't write these down for funsies. I wrote these down because it's a good process to follow to make sure you're doing it correctly. Funsies a word. I think it should be. Once you're done, look over at whoever you're sitting next to, see if they got the same thing. If they didn't, talk through it. See if you made a mistake, see if they made a mistake. if you didn't get it right, look at that person's work. I recommend trying to sit next to somebody. All right, what did you guys get?
I got -4 or -5.
Raise your hand if you got it. Seems like most people got -4/5. All right, so let's walk through it. Raise your hand if you can help me with the first step. It seems like most people got it, so I want people who haven't participated yet to try to participate. Oh, wait. Nick.
Subtract
3y from both sides. Good. So that's because 3y minus 3y is 0. So on the right-hand side, I have 8. On the left-hand side, I have 4 minus 5y. Okay, who can help Nick? What's the next step? I don't know what your name is. I'm sorry. Jake. You didn't tell me Jake. You didn't tell me Jake. Okay. Subtract 4 from each side. And what do you get?
-5y = 4.
Good. Okay. So step 1, get everything with a y to one side. Step 2, get everything without a y to the other side. Good. So we're there. Step 3 is solve. So who can help? Nick and Jake.
Divide by -5.
Divide both sides by -5. That's because -5, the operation between -5 and y is multiplication. The opposite of multiplication is division. So I get y equals -4/5. Good. Seems like you guys mostly got it, yeah? All right, let's do another. So is there anything that needs clarification? Is there anything you guys don't like? Did you guys get it here? Okay. All right, let's make it a little more fun. Huh? Didn't know you were gonna have so much fun at 10 o'clock in the morning. All right. Again, try to do it by yourself. If you get stuck somewhere, have a little chat with your partner. So before we get too far, who can tell me the first step? First step is get everything with a y on one side, everything without a y on the other side. So who can help me with that?
Add
1/2 y. So 1/2 y plus 1/2 y is what? It's 1 y. So then I'm going to have y here and y here. So my goal hasn't been met. So think about it again, Luke. Simple fix, right? Subtract. Because 1/2 minus 1/2 is 0. Good. So let's subtract. Right? The goal is to get everything with a y on one side. Okay, so I have -6 equals, oh my goodness, 1/5 minus 1/2. Oh gosh. Let's write that out.
Common denominator.
1/5 minus 1/2. So earlier we said common denominator. What's the common denominator between 1/5 and 1/2? 10. Good. So what do I need to do to these?
Convert them into tens. Or tenths. Or.
So how do I do it? This is what I see a lot of. Somebody tell me? Go ahead, Meadow.
You would multiply
1/5
by 2 and then to get the.
So multiply by 2. Times 5. Okay, so if we do this, what do we get? We multiply numerator times numerator, denominator times denominator. So this would be 2/5 minus 5/2.
Sorry.
No, don't be sorry. So that didn't get we don't have a common denominator, right? Okay, so one more time, help me. So it's okay. But I don't know how to write it.
I mean, you multiply numerator and denominator by the number, I mean, granted that one always be. Or is
So you multiply numerator and denominator by the number. So like by 2 over 2? Is that what you mean?
Yeah, and then you can multiply the other one by 5 over 5.
And then you multiply this by 5 over 5. Okay, so why is this okay to do?
Because it gets you a common denominator.
Because it gets you a common, so it helps us reach our goal, but why is it mathematically allowed?
There's pretty much still the same number, it's just written in a different manner.
That's very true. They're the same number, but they're written in a different manner. What am I really multiplying by here?
One.
Multiply by one all day, friends. Have a great time. You can multiply by one anytime you want to, and that's allowed, right? I could add zero anytime I wanted to, and that's allowed. So the thing is some people say multiply by two. Some people say multiply by one half. Not okay. You'd be changing everything about the problem. You need to multiply by a factor of one. Okay? Then you can do it. So again, we said multiplying fractions, I multiply numerator times numerator and denominator times denominator. Numerator times numerator, denominator times denominator. Okay, so I have a common denominator. Good. So you have to multiply by a factor of one. For some reason, I get all kinds of answers for that. Okay, so now I'm subtracting fractions. So I combine the numerator and keep the denominator the same. So I'm writing out all of the steps I know, but we need to bring it back. So I get negative 3 over 10. Okay, good. So let's put that in here. So that's for this, right? So I got 1/5 minus 1/2 is negative 3 over 10. Why? And then plus 3. Okay, good. So I got everything with a y on one side. Now I need to get everything without a y on the other side. So now you guys can finish this, right? Just might have needed a little refresh. So now you guys finish this. Talk to your partner. We have 2 more minutes. Talk to your partner. I'm going to write out my answer. Try it on your own, okay? So only look up once you've tried, because I'm writing the answer. Or really try it on your own. Did I get it right?
Mm-hmm.
Did you get it right?
I mean, I took a bit of a different path to get there, but that's because I tried to focus on keeping the numbers positive and avoid negatives if possible.
So if that's what works for you, that's what works for you. But the first step is get everything with a Y on one side.
What matters is the destination, not the journey.
The second step is get everything with a Y on the other side. And then the third step is to solve. In the end, you should get the same answer. If you did all the steps mathematically correct and you got the same answer, if you did it in a different order, that's not really important. The important thing is you got the right answer and you did the steps correctly. So are we all good? We all agree? Any questions? Okay. So we'll have to finish this section up next time.